a votary of truth. Dr. M.B. Srinivas. Dr. M.B. Srinivas was a brilliant student and a scholar of history who studied intermediate course at Tumkur between 1951 to 1952. He earned a fourth rank for the state and pursued B.A. honors between 1953 and 55 at Maharaja College, Mysore. He passed out of B.A. honors with distinction, first rank, 3 gold medals, and M.A. in history, 1955-56, with a first rank and a gold medal. He was a student of Dr. Srikanta Sastri and began his research career under his guidance. He wrote the novel Ratnakara in collaboration with Professor Brahmappa. This novel won Karnataka Government Sahitya Academy Award for 1961. He has carried on his research work on a scholarship at Jawaharlal Nehru University in 1966 and a Fulbright's Fellowship to study at Columbia University, USA in 1968. He has taught history at undergraduate and postgraduate levels for 40 years. He has guided 12 PhD scholars and published a number of books and articles in Kannada and English.
Mysore University has produced many great scholars in the last century. Dr. Srikanta Sastri is one of the great professors who served in the Department of History of Mysore University. He was a dedicated scholar and a prolific writer. He taught us cultural history in B.A. honors and M.A. classes. Dr. Sastri's scholarship was not limited to history. He had specialized in literature, languages, epigraphy, art, architecture, and other subjects. He wrote articles on subjects like religion, philosophy, epigraphy, architecture, etc. Any new topic or controversy in Karnataka history drew his attention. He immediately responded and produced astonishingly original theories and views. He was very quick to respond to the controversy over the work Sri Bhuvalaya. He was equally at ease in writing on Vedic astronomy and mathematics. Professor Srikanta Sastri's remarks that the Vedic community could have been a sizable section of the Harappan society appears to be not only cogent but also highly probable in view of the geographical extent. He examined ancient Indian culture from philosophical, anthropological, archaeological point of view and threw new lights on many subjects. Dr. Srikanta Sastri took up research at a very young age. He came forward to critically examine Oswald Spengler's theory of history. Spengler was a great European scholar. Professor Sastri pointed out that Spengler's observations on growth of Indian culture and spirituality was erroneous. So Srikanta Sastri not only pointed out the limitations and the defects of Spengler's theory, he came up with another very, very relevant picture or theory about Spengler's views. Professor Sastri had a profound knowledge of Kannada and Telugu literature. His students who studied language and literature considered him a great scholar. He wrote research articles in the book reviews in several newspapers and magazines. Professor Sastri was very soft-spoken. He was a dignified personality. His dignified personality impressed his students and others who came into contact with him. Dr. Sastri would always welcome any kind of intellectual discussion. He was prepared to throw light and clear any kind of doubt on any subject. I remember my days with Professor Sastri. I used to walk with him where he would just take us to the subject. The moment he opened his discussion, we were lifted from that geographical area. We were taken to the Ganga's court, King's court, where a discussion was going on. So Srikanta Sastri had that power of producing a particular scene in the history and making us viewers. In that way, he not only taught, he showed us the real content of history, and we were able to understand, appreciate history. So we were, three students were very lucky, very grateful, and particularly I was very much benefited by scholarship. Whenever I had a doubt, I would just go and ask him about this. He would just smile and give a reply. He had an encyclopedic knowledge. From ancient India to modern, from one country to another, he knew 14 languages. With that knowledge, he wrote on many fields. History has innumerable branches and fields, and generally it is not easy, it's not possible to master them. But he had that rare capacity. In spite of many odds and difficulties. Yes, now I have to say something very unpleasant. Maybe in his period, or maybe in our this is the bane of our culture and our national life. He was harassed. He was denied many facilities and promotions and many other important and very true directions which he deserved. So all those things were denied, and there was some kind of a conspiracy to take away and stop his publications and give him some kind of torture. I was disgusted. Some people were deliberately trying to picture him as something who does not know history, modern history, like that. All this points out what a great man I've always have passed through some stages of difficulty and danger. But Dr. Shastri's concentration was not disturbed. He always gave his complete time, energy to growth of history. Sources of Karnataka history. It's not a very easy to find out at that time. It is a virgin subject. Nobody had done that. He had to go around and produce that. And that is a source for any person who wants to study Karnataka history. Professor Shastri has given that foundation. He enriched Karnataka history. He strengthened the roots of research and development and the study of history. So he is a role model. He is an inspiration.
Professor Seetaram Jagirdar. Professor Seetaram Jagirdar was born in 1935 and graduated from Osmania University, Hyderabad, with a MA in Kannada degree in first class first. He retired as chief epigraphist from Institute of Kannada Studies. He has worked as a co-editor for Epigraphia Karnataka, Volume 1 to 8. He has been a chief editor of Volume 9 of Epigraphia Karnataka. He has written 20 books and published more than 100 research articles. He has been a recipient of Kayaka Prashasti 1998, Shasana Shastra Visharata from the Shravana Belgol Mutt, and Karnataka State Government Rajyotswa Award in the year 2017.
Dr. Srikanta Sastri galu Karnataka go kanda obba mahan vidwansaru desha kaanta irutade avaga avaga nakshatragalu bartirtave balaku beertirtave hogtirtave kelavon sala avu janara kannige beeltave kelu sala ಕಣ್ಣಿಗೆ ಬೀಳದೆ ಹಾಗೆ ಜಾರಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತವೆ ಚಿತ್ತಿಜದಲ್ಲಿ. ಹಾಗೆ ಈಗ ಹಾಗೆ ಅನಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದೆ, ಶ್ರೀಕಂಠ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳನ್ನು ನೆನೆಸಿಕೊಳ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಜನ ಬಹಳ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆದರೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಾಲ್ಯದ ಕಾಲಕ್ಕಾಗಲಿ, ನಮ್ಮ ಒಂದು ವಿದ್ಯೆಯನ್ನು ಆರ್ಜಿಸತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಕಾಲದಲ್ಲಾಗಲಿ ಆ ಥರ ಏನಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಶ್ರೀಕಂಠ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳು ಇಡೀ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ತುಂಬ ಪ್ರಸಿದ್ಧವಾದಂಥ ಒಬ್ಬ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರು ಮತ್ತು ಬಹಳ ಬರೆದಂಥ ಬರಹಗಾರ. ಅದರಲ್ಲೂ ಇತಿಹಾಸ, ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಇತಿಹಾಸ, ಭಾರತದ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಪಂಚದ ಇತಿಹಾಸ, ಮೂರುಗಳನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಒಂದು ತ್ರಿವಳಿಯನ್ನು ಹೊಂದಿರತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮಹಾನುಭಾವರು. ಆ ವಿಷಯ ಅಂದರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಮಟ್ಟಿಗೆ ಓದಿದ್ದು ಅಂತ ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳನ್ನು ನೋಡಿದರೆ ನಾವು ಬೆರಗು ಬಿಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ, ಅಚ್ಚರಿ ಪಡಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಬಹುಶಃ ಅಷ್ಟು ಪುಸ್ತಕವನ್ನು ನಾವು ಕಣ್ಣಾಡಿಸಬಲ್ಲವೆ ಅಂತ. ಆದರೆ ವಾಸ್ತವ ಅವರು ಕಣ್ಣಾಡಿಸಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅಷ್ಟಾರು ಹತ್ತಾರು ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳನ್ನು ಅಲ್ಲ, ನೂರಾರು ಪುಸ್ತಕಗಳನ್ನು ಅಧ್ಯಯನ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಅವುಗಳಿಂದ ಸಂಗತಿಗಳನ್ನು ಎತ್ತಿಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಬೆಳಕನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸಬೇಕಾದಲ್ಲಿ ಜಗತ್ತಿನ ಮುಂದೆ ಅವುಗಳನ್ನು ಇಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಹೊಸದನ್ನು ಬೆಳಗಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಆ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ತಮ್ಮಷ್ಟಕ್ಕೆ ತಾವೇ ಅಲ್ಲ, ಯಾವುದೇ ಒಂದು ವಸ್ತು ಬೆಳಕಾಗಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ತನ್ನ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಒಂದು ಬೆಳಕಿನ ಶಕ್ತಿಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ಇಟ್ಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕಾಗ್ತದೆ. ಅವೆಲ್ಲ ಸೆಲ್ಗಳಂತೆ ಇವರು ಅದರ ಬಲ್ಬ್ ಇದ್ದಂತೆ. ಅವ್ರನ್ನ ನಾವು ನಾಡಹಬ್ಬಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿಗೆ ಆಹ್ವಾನಿಸಿದ್ವಿ. ಅವರು ಶ್ರೀಕಂಠ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಪಟ್ಟಂತಹ ಒಂದು ಅತ್ಯುತ್ತಮ ಅಭಿಪ್ರಾಯವನ್ನು ಪ್ರಾಯಶಃ ಯಾವ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿಯೂ ಮರೆಯಬಾರದು, ಮರೆಯಲಾರದಂಥ ಸಹಾಯವನ್ನು ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿದರು ಅಂತ ತರಾಸು ಅವರು ನೆನೆಸಿಕೊಂಡರು ನನಗೆ ಹೈದರಾಬಾದಿನಲ್ಲಿ. ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ಅವರು ಕೊಟ್ಟವರಲ್ಲ, ವಾಸ್ತವದಲ್ಲಿ ಅವರ ಪದತಲದಲ್ಲಿ ಕುಳಿತು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಎಂ.ಎ. ವಿದ್ಯಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ಅಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೆ ಒಬ್ಬ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಉತ್ತಮ ಬರಹಗಾರ, ಇನ್ನೊಬ್ಬ ವಿದ್ವಾಂಸರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಯಾವ ಥರ ನಡೆದುಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಒಂದು ನಡಾವಳಿಯನ್ನು ತೋರಿಸಿಕೊಟ್ಟಂಥ ಮಹಾನುಭಾವರು ಶ್ರೀಕಂಠ.
ನಿಮ್ಮ
ಹಾಗೆ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕದ ಇತಿಹಾಸ ಬರೆಯೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಶ್ರೀಕಂಠ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳು ಕೂಡ ಡೈನ್ ಆಫ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಹೇಳ್ತೇನೆ. ಈ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಅಮಂಗ್ ದ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಹೂ ನ್ಯಾರೇಟೆಡ್ ಕರ್ನಾಟಕ ಹಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಥರೋಲಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ವೆಲ್ ಅಂತ ನನಗನ್ನಿಸ್ತದೆ. ಆ ಕಾರಣದ ವಿದ್ವತ್ ವಲಯವನ್ನು ನೋಡುವಾಗ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳ ಕುರಿತು ನಾವು ಕೆಟ್ಟ ಮಾತನ್ನು ಎಂದೂ ಹೇಳಬಾರದು. ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಕೆಲಸ ಏನಿದೆ ಅದು ಬಹಳ ಉತ್ತಮ ಮಟ್ಟದ್ದು, ಮತ್ತು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಆಗಿನ ಕಾಲಕ್ಕೆ ಅದು ಸರಿ. ಅನಂತರದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವೇನಾದರೂ ಬದಲಾವಣೆಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಳಬೇಕು. ಆದರೆ ಅವರು ಮಾಡಿದಂಥ ಆ ದೊಡ್ಡ ಕೆಲಸ ನಿಮಗೆ 1000 ಪುಟಗಳ ಮೇಲೆ 2 ವಾಲ್ಯೂಮ್ ಇದೆ ಇಂಗ್ಲೀಷ್ನಲ್ಲಿ. ಯಾವುದೇ ಧರ್ಮ ಆಚರಿಸಲಿ ಅದು ಭಗವಂತ ಇದ್ದಾನೆ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ಏಕಂಸತ್ವ ವಿಪ್ರಾ ಬಹುಧಾ ವದಂತಿ ಅಂತ ವೇದ ಕಾಲದಿಂದಲೇ ಬಂದಿದೆ. ಎಷ್ಟು ಭೇದ ಭಾವಗಳಿತ್ತು ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮಾತು ಆ ಬಸವಣ್ಣನವರು ಅದನ್ನೇ ಅನುವಾದ ಮಾಡಿಟ್ರು, ದೇವನಪ್ಪ ನಾಮ ಹಲವು ಅಂತ. ಅನೇಕರಿಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಿಲ್ಲ ಇದು ವೇದದ ಒಂದು ವಾಕ್ಯ, ಕನ್ನಡದಲ್ಲಿ ಕನ್ನಡಿಸಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾನೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಬಸವಣ್ಣ ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದು. ಅಣ್ಣ ಬಸವಣ್ಣನ ಬಗೆಗೂ ನನಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಗೌರವ ಇದೆ, ಆ ಧರ್ಮದ ಬಗೆಗೂ ನನಗೆ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಪ್ರೀತಿ ವಿಶ್ವಾಸ. ಯಾವ ಧರ್ಮಕ್ಕೂ ನಾವು ವಿರೋಧಿಸುವ ಅವಶ್ಯಕತೆ ಇಲ್ಲ. ಯಾವುದು ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾಗಿದೆ, ಒಳ್ಳೆಯದಾದದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸ್ವೀಕಾರ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು, ಒಳ್ಳೆಯ ರೀತಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಬದುಕಬೇಕು. ಇದನ್ನೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಿಗಳು ತಮ್ಮ ಬರವಣಿಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ಎಲ್ಲ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ. ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ತುಂಬ ಎಚ್ಚರದಿಂದ ನೆನಪಿಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂತ ತಿಳಿದುಕೊಂಡು ಅವರ ಒಂದು ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಾವು ನಡೆದರೆ ಬಹುಶಃ ನಮ್ಮ ಇತಿಹಾಸವನ್ನು ಸರಿಯಾಗಿ ನಡೆಸಿಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ತೀವಿ ಅಂತ ನಾನು ಅಂದ್ಕೊಂಡಿದ್ದೇನೆ.